Tarnished the Elden Lord, episode 5. Welcome back to another episode of Elden Ring. And last time, previously, got destroyed trying to enter into this castle right here by that crossbow up on the top. So, this time, we're gonna dodge that, make our way through. Look at that, boom. Took out the enemy instead. Lovely. Take out these knights. Absolutely miss. Jesus. That's not great. Let's get off the horse here. Take this guy on. And I absolutely got wrecked. That is unlucky. Alright. Well, take two. Take two. We got this. Head up again. And take this guy first, because he was a problem last time. Get the golden seed. Need that for the future. Miss all my hits. Absolutely wonderful. At least you got that dude. Miss that, miss that. What am I even swinging at? I don't know. Mostly, my horse combat is not the greatest. But it's okay because I get them eventually. Oh. At least I learned that I could attack on both sides and I didn't just attack on the right side of the horse. That was unfortunate, like, 4 episodes where I was still figuring out the game's mechanics. There's Big Chief over there, he's obviously.
Big guy over there is really difficult. Ready? I'll get hit by him once just so you can see how much damage he does. Ready? Oh my god, I almost just died.
He's really informing the youth, you know, teaching them the true culture.
Yeah, because he has a really special
ability.
Yeah, I'm gonna die. Ready?
Close. Pop a potion, return to camp, so I can get my flasks back up to full. And of course, we're gonna hit a level up while we're at it.
Yeah.
Now, time to beat Mr. Pumpkin Man over here. So we head back up. Take out these troops, because, you know, gotta thin them out a little bit. I'll smack the pumpkin man a little bit here and there while I can, when he's off guard. Now, this was very scary, but I somehow managed to get out of there unharmed, with the power of rolling. Sweet relief. Well, he's coming. Let's get out of here. Chuck a very silly roll, which I almost ruined my life. Hit the shield. Get out of there alive, which is always a win. Okay, call upon the popos. And then use the dogs as a bait so that I can take out the pumpkin. Boom. He's defeated. Victory. Get a sanctuary stone, smithing stones, we'll need those in the future. And now we finally get to enter the castle. I originally thought this was a giant enemy just playing dead, so I was a little bit stressed out and thought I should try and attack it first. But I realized it's actually just a fox. So, crack creatures. Getting absolutely bombarded. So I decided, maybe if I lock on, I can see him and dodge better. And I did not at all. continue the siege. Absolutely shrekking. Jesus. He was so far off, but okay. Head into this cute little room, and we get a cooking book. Lovely. The doggos are putting in the work. Respectful rooms. Loyal companions, my friends. Loyal companions. Then, head up these stairs. Huh? Ah, you bastard. This is sweet revenge. That's what you get. That is what you get. Anyways, head up the stairs, take out this guy, and easy peasy. Jesus, and then I get knocked off the edge by that guy. I almost died.
That was so close.
And he followed me. That was honestly the most terrifying moment of
my life. I just fell off the top of the tower.
Thank God I have doggos. Calm the nerves, pop a potion, head back into the battle, support them. I don't want to die on me. I love my dogs.
Yeah, those.
Jesus.
Friends. That's something. They're like ghosts.
Hit him with the. Yahoo! Take him out, and we get an Ash of War. This one is actually very important and becomes a vital part of my build throughout the series, so. Just to sit there and explain the game a little bit more to the youngling. And we head up this ladder, climb up. Over to this lovely little chest. And we get the left half of a medallion. Very lovely. Head back. Take out the bow because I got mad. And we can keep on heading. Explore around a little bit. I just had to leave a warning because, you know, I fell off. Surely someone else will too. There we go. Be wary of fleeing. Lovely. Okay. Decided to explore around, make sure I didn't miss anything before I left. And yeah. Honestly, didn't find anything. Yeah, I thought that was a hidden passage, but obviously not. I was exploring around, I saw this file, and realized there was a merchant over there. So, lovely. We can head over, sell some more stuff.
Welcome.
Get the Schmeckles.
Yes, right this way. Right. Welcome, valued customer. Come, trade in our wandering emporium. Please, buy something. I'm hungry. I've been hungry so long.
Jesus. Please. I feel bad for this dude. So, obviously, I gotta give him all my stuff and sell it all. I don't think I even bought anything. I just sold things to him. So, he just got loot. I'm sure he could eat something I gave him. Head over here, take care of this bear, get some runes, continue onward. Then we try and clear out these little gabagoos. I don't know if they're monkeys, I don't know if they're... I don't know what they are. Little gremlins. But they're a cool enemy to fight, I enjoy them. Hit him with the... And... I don't know their attack methods, so I'm just gonna get smacked. Oh, I'm getting smacked around left, right, center. Jesus. Bruh. I almost died. That was so close. Now it's time to take this dude out. Special attack. Drawing units. Let's go. Victory. And read these. And I'm surprised I didn't find the merchant in the last episode. I even read that shining little, finger message, I guess you could say. So I went around, adventured around, obviously killing everything and taking everything I could the way of the pillager. And I found these schmeckles, so obviously I had to collect them all. Did some parkour. Missed that jump because it's a bit too far away. I mean, this doggo had a little bit of a stare off before we did a lot of detail with the twin blade. Respect. Continue on, collected all the schmeckles, because they're very important for later. Is that Skyrim music in the background? I'm gonna say no for copyright reasons, but you can have your own opinion on that. And this doggo just kept on dodging all my attacks and running away. So it was a bit frustrating, but got him eventually. Playing soccer with that skull, but we got the rune in the end. Sadly, I need the souls, I need the runes. So I have to kill everything. I do feel bad about killing some of the doggos and, you know, even the bears sometimes. It's very unfortunate that you have to murder everything in order to progress. Anyways, found more schmeckles, which is absolutely lovely. Had to secure the area so I didn't get killed. But once that was done, got all the schmeckles. Had to take out that one last wolf. And we head on. Found these flower things. No idea what they were, so I just hit them with the flames. Realize that magic dust is probably bad for me to inhale, so I stayed back for a little bit before I continued on and slayed him. Took out this one. Bam. And then I realized there's a huge one. I'm very confused about the lightning spikes, but it's fine. I dodged it. There's a boss? Lovely. But first, there was this dude, so stay out of there. Don't know how much damage it does, but I don't know about it. Hit him with a reasonable amount. Play cautiously. I don't want to die. I may have 53 deaths. And what, 5 episodes in? 6 episodes in? I don't even know what episode we're up to now. I said at the start it was 5. Don't mind me. Called upon the doggos. They were getting destroyed, so I had to come in there and save them. It was a bit dangerous though, so obviously I don't know. Got the sweet victory. Saved 2 of the doggos, which is the most important part. And then explored around a little bit, just to see what's in the area. Nothing much, so I kind of headed back over. Realized, oh, there's some guys up here. I wanted to knock him off, but he fell backwards, which was quite unfortunate. Got the gold pickled Valflet, which is important for later. And I was in the middle of doing something, so I wasn't paying attention and almost ran off the cliff and stopped just in time. All for some crackers. What a cracker. Anyways. Just enjoyed the tree over there. Quite beautiful sight. I saw this item up there. Realized I need the horse to get up there. But I'm not very good at horse maneuvering, as we all know. Now I gotta turn. Is that possible? No. Alright. Get up. Then off the horse. And then. There we go. Look at that. Apparently that's a necessary item, but I'm pretty sure I sold it anyways. Alright, well, thought about trying the boss, but I also thought I don't want to lose all my runes after I'm so obsessed on leveling up and getting them, and as well as improving my weaponry. Chucked a little sneak. Bop. He noticed me. I had to get out of there quick. And initiated the 1v1 with that FP, which is not good. And that's even worse. And then I realized it was game over. I accepted my fate. Ate a cracker and moved on. Alright. Now it's time to recover those souls. Kinda got a little bit lost over there, but I remembered a little updraft that I can boost up. For some reason there was a whole army there. Lovely. Just thought, nah, I'm dipping. Saw this thing, I thought, maybe it dropped something. Let's see. I was foolish enough not to read all the text around it and realized that it was a friend. It was a friend the whole time. I could have just sat down next to it. You know, soaked in some peace. But obviously, I committed an atrocity and murdered poor friend. Head it over here. Take out some guys, got a sliver of meat. Found this grace. Always important to capture these while you can. And you're gonna level up. Look at that. And that's why you don't do the boss, otherwise I would have lost that level up. That would have been unfortunate. And looks like I'm going with strength. I'm pretty sure that is so then I can use the shield. Potentially. Or potentially not. I think I was actually just evening out the build. But, of course, had to go around, collect more schmeckles. Harvest the souls. And I got absolutely more. Which is not good. And then, very dangerous moment. Slam into the potion. Heal up. The best aim in the world. And comboed. Like twice in a row. I survived. Thank God. Took them all out with ease. Moved on, and then decided to face a small army on my own and, you know, get involved in a civil war right here. Alright, that's easy. Over and done with, so head over. Took down a big chunk of it. Watch me fail misery for too long, you know. I got smacked. Unfortunate. And in a very bad position, got triple here. So I decided to dip out of there. Chuck a little here. Really don't like these big guys with the dismounted swords. They are not fun to verse. Like, why are you gonna be so tanky, you know? And then I unfortunately killed myself by running off the edge. Yes, that did happen.
I fell off a really tall bridge.
Now to retrieve the runes. special ore on sheath. Always good. Collect everything we can. I thought I could collect at the bottom, but apparently not. Apparently I need to be up the top. Took these guys out. Less problems. Got on the horse. I have to deal with this guy a bunch. Once I gathered my runes, I knew it was time. Take him out. Lovely super damage. And then he glitched and did a little backflip. Interesting. I don't know why I switched to the war pick here. For some reason, I was just, I don't know, frustrated and just switched up. I almost died, but with the power of rolling, I live. The most important mechanic in the game, the ability to roll around. Summon the walls once again. Almost. Unfortunately die here. Sniped point blank. Impressive.
Yeah.
But I really hit him with that no scope. Now, I had to go find my souls. Once again. Don't you just love this game? You die. And then you go and try and recover, and then you die again, and you get bonked by little rookie enemies that you can pretty much two tap. These guys aren't even hard, I'm just failing. Look at that, I didn't even hit them with that. What is even that? And I just got to a very dangerous position. I had to lock in here, because I don't want to die. Boom. Too good. Rolled out of there, popped the potion. Chucked on the horse. Let's use like, creatures again. Monkey men, I don't even know what they are. Little gremlin dudes. We took them out. Nice and easy. Head over here. I then realized, oh, that's right, because I did that castle. I'm gonna talk to my friend.
Did you manage? Oh, excellent. Well done.
What do you have for me, my friend?
Go ahead.
Ooh, that's your dagger. Let's see. What do we get? It's not bad, actually. Pretty good little dagger. Found some more runes, so obviously I had to steal from these graves. They don't need any more, they're dead. Got another cookbook. Currently talking to the youngling about Minecraft. Cause he's doing some grinding on a world that we can share.
Is that cause it keep inventory?
Anyways, I noticed there was some little steps up there, so I thought, you know, gotta do the little skill jumps. Okay, let's go. First one complete. I don't think I'm gonna make that without the horse, so. Oh. Missed it on the cycle. There we go. Okay, let's turn around. No, no. I'm not very good at this. Anyways, I died again. Sitting us at 56 deaths. So now we're gonna go and recover those runes. Figured I might as well take a shortcut, go this way. Took out that ball, don't know really what it does. Not sure how I'm supposed to get down because it's a huge cliff. Yeah, I do know you can use those little updrafts going downwards, but for some reason I decided to run on the side of the cliff and kill myself again. And lose all my runes. Yeah. That did happen. Regret.
Guess what? I just lost, like, the equivalent of probably, like, 30 experience in Minecraft in this game. Every single time you die, you lose all your money, and that's like your experience.
After a short exclamation, I had to take some more souls because obviously I just lost all of my grinding, which is unfortunate. So, we're gonna take on this crab. And unfortunately, he actually ended up bonking me. Pretty hard. Right there. That was very unfortunate. But still managed to pop the potion, survive. Which is all it's about. As long as you live. As long as you keep on going. That's back twice. But that didn't stop me. Took him out, took out a whole bunch of other guys, headed over to the Dragonbone ruins. Oh yeah. Lovely. Just purify the area, get rid of all the enemies. There we go. Down here, and there's some rats. Taking on heavy damage, so I need to leave there ASAP, otherwise I was gonna die. Popped a potion. I thought that was him behind the body, but he was actually just a little bit down further. And take out the last one. And now, if you've played this game before, you know that the chest ahead is not a friendly chest. But unfortunately, I didn't know that because I didn't read a single message on the way in. I just thought, that's got to be good. It's loot. It was not loot. Unfortunately, it sent me somewhere else. And as I sit there, patiently waiting for it to load, something incredibly unfortunate happens. I'm stressing. Thinking about what's going to happen on the other side of the loading screen. But unfortunately, I never get there. Because the game crashed.
It crashed?
Okay. So, I relaunched the game. Hoping that maybe it was just, you know, some random accident. It's not looking promising. I've been sitting there waiting for like 4 minutes for this and nothing's happened so far. So I actually needed to validate my files because there was a problem with the files on my computer, which basically meant like most of the game wasn't loading properly, like most of the map wasn't loading properly. But I'd never been to that area, so how would I know? Obviously I didn't know this at the time. I thought I lost it all. This time, I thought, maybe if I launch it through the character screen, it'll be better, you know? Sending all my positive energy, channeling in good energy, good intentions, power of God.
Please, may the run not be absolutely destroyed.
I'm just hoping that my save file wasn't corrupt and I didn't lose all the progress that I've recorded so far, which was quite a lot of hours.
No.
I thought I just lost it forever, and I just lost Ghilda the Broke. In despair, I stare at the camera, pull it forth. Was it all for nothing? No, can't be.
Lose anything.
Losing my sanity. 13 hours. Is it all gone? Subscribe. Find out more.